I want you to breathe in and clear your mind. Now wave your hand. Look around the room you're sitting in. Breathe out. All those actions were possible because you possess something very special, a brain. The brain is responsible for your conscious, like awake, and unconscious, like asleep actions. This is a video that will go through the basic regions of the brain and what performs which function. The brain is really complicated and we haven't got it all figured out yet, but by using science, we can explain a little of what's going on. Let's start with neurons, the basic building blocks of the brain. Neurons act in groups where each neuron type has a specific function. It could be a neuron type for faces or tastes or color or hunger. For the brain to send a message, it doesn't just use one neuron, but many of them at the same time. The more neurons sending a message, the likelier it is to be read by the brain. It's easier for neurons to act with nearby neurons versus those farther away. So different messages will come from different areas of the brain sent by different groups of neurons. For instance, the ones I'm showing you here. We know that neurons act in group to do similar actions. So here's a way to think about which parts of the brain do what. For example, let's start with the most basic of actions, the ones you aren't even 100% conscious of. Without doing anything, your heartbeat, breathing, excitatory, hunger, and sleep levels are all being run by the brainstem. If you look at this model, you'll see the brainstem is located right below the base of the skull. In fact, you can just as easily use your hand as a model for the brain by curling it up like so. The brainstem would be where the wrist is, right below the base of the skull. And the cortex and limbic system, which we'll go into later, would be located likewise there and there. You try. This part of our brain is similar to a lizard's brain in terms of function. This is because we both share a common ancestor. Our brainstem is our reflex response system, connected to deep drives to act in certain ways, for instance by eating when you're hungry. But we don't only respond automatically to things, we also have feelings. This comes from the limbic region, which is located in the middle of your brain. Feelings can have a huge effect on our actions and can allow us to connect with other humans as social creatures. When I get a compliment or look off the side of a really tall building, my limbic system sends signals throughout my body about whether to feel warm and fuzzy inside or be paralyzed by fear. Short-term memories are also stored in this area, which may explain why emotional events make long-lasting memories, since the neurons for both are sending messages as a group. So, I can breathe, sleep, and feel fear, but what about thinking, planning, feeling, seeing, hearing, smelling, tasting, and understanding the world? All of these things are done by the cortex, which is the biggest part of the brain. In humans, it's located here. This is the part of our brain that separates humans from other mammals and mammals from farther ancestors. Overall, the cortex gives us long-term memory, reason, and free will. We can point out the occipital lobe in the back of our head, which is where your sight and ability to understand what you're seeing come from. At the top of the head is the parietal lobe, which stores sensory data from the body. In fact, the brain's folds have been mapped to certain body parts. The temporal lobe runs down the side of your head and takes care of how you hear, as well as holding memories and emotions like the limbic region, which it's right next to. Lastly, right at our forehead is the frontal lobe, which organizes all the planning and coordinated movement and that allows us to dream, build, and think about the future. Using these regions, your brain is capable of infinite actions. Even as you watch this video, you are using your occipital and frontal lobes to see, process what you see, and think about how cool neuroscience is. You can trace any of your actions back to a specific region in the brain and even show where a few might be using your handy hand model. Where's sadness, your sense of taste, your ability to feel empathy? All these and more are locked in your brain, but organized in such a way that we can make sense of it and marvel at how smart our brain really is.